नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम जेविन डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ इंस्टीट्यूट जयपुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक एक्टिनोमाइसिटीज. व्हाट आर द स्ट्रेप्टोमाइसिस? सो माई टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज स्ट्रेप्टोमाइसिस. What are the streptomyces? Streptomyces are actually the largest genus of the actinomycetes. So before understanding of the streptomyces, first of all we must understand what are the actinomycetes. Actinomycetes are actually the bacteria. They are actually bacteria and they are filamentous bacteria. Bacteria are not filamentous, but actinomycetes are filamentous bacteria, filamentous in structure. They have filaments, they have mycelium. So actinomycetes are filamentous gram-positive bacteria. And they are organisms which have both characteristics of bacteria and fungi. Okay, so they are different from the bacteria. Similarly, they are different from the fungi. Similarly, we can also say that they are similar to bacteria and they are similar to fungi. Okay, actinomycetes are clubbed with the bacteria, the same class of schizomycetes, and they are unicellular like bacteria, but produce a mycelium which is non-separate. They have mycelium. They are unicellular, single, they have single cell. Okay, so they are included into to the prokaryotic. But what is the difference of these actinomycetes from the bacteria? The difference is that they have mycelium, they produce mycelium which is non-septate. Okay, they are not like true bacteria. They cannot be said the true bacteria, but they have some characteristics which are similar to true bacteria. Okay, and they do not have distinct cell wall, and their cell wall is without chitin and cellulose. And in the culture media, they form some colonies of slime colonies. Okay, their colonies on the culture media is very slow, and they may show the powdery consistency on the agar surface. And similarly, they produce hyphae and conidia just like fungi. So there is dissimilarity from the bacteria. They are similar, in some terms they are similar to fungi also. Okay. And actinomycetes are numerous and widely distributed in soil and are next to the bacteria in abundance. Okay, the most found species are of bacteria. The second one is actinomycetes in the prokaryotic, and they are widely distributed in the soil. Okay, they are found in the soil, compost, etc. And when we count the plates on the agar media, we can found a value of 10^4 to 10^8 actinomycetes per gram in the soil. And they are sensitive to acidic pH, but they can be found at the pH range of 6.5 to 8. That is like the fungi. Fungi are also found in this pH range. They are heterotrophic, aerobic, and mesophilic in nature. That means they can be found in different temperature ranges. Most of them are extremophiles, such as they can tolerate temperature of 55 to 65 degrees centigrade. Actinomycetes, the one of the most important genera is Streptomyces, because they are most in abundance in the soil. The another genus which are found in the actinomycetes include the Nocardia, Macro, Monospora. Okay, so these are the genus which are found in the soil, which are included into the actinomycetes family. Function, what are the function of the actinomycetes? They degrade, decompose the organic substance like cellulose, polysaccharide, proteins, organic residues, and substances which are found in the soil are first attacked by bacteria and fungi, and they are the actinomycetes are the third one which grow on these organic residues. These actinomycetes decompose and degrade the more resistant and indecomposable organic substances. They are also responsible for the subsequent decomposition of humus, and they are responsible for the earthy smell of the soil. Means if we smell on the loved soil, then we find an earthy smell. This earthy smell is due to the presence of actinomycetes. Many genera of actinomycetes produce number of antibiotics like streptomycin, teramycin, and oromycin. So these antibiotics are isolated from these actinomycetes. Okay, so they are commercially and therapeutically very important. One of the species of actinomycetes is streptomycin, which causes potato stub in the potato. So they are also harmful for the plants. So this is the structure of actinomycetes. This is the hyphae structure of actinomycetes. This is the conidia, which is found in the actinomycetes, and it is a hyphae. Hyphae is the basic structure, cellular structure of the actinomycetes. They are gram-positive bacteria, they are filamentous formics, they also form some spores. Example include the streptomyces and the nocardia. Now we come to our topic, streptomyces. What are the streptomyces? Streptomyces is the one of the most largest genus of the actinomycetes. And in the streptomyces, over 500 species are known. They have some branching structures, and the growth of these streptomyces is at the tip of the filaments. Means this is tip, so they are found in the tip of the filament. Okay. Vegetative form phase is found in the streptomyces, which is tightly woven matrix, result in a compact convoluted mycelium and subsequent colonies which are observed in the streptomyces. When these streptomyces get their growth, and the area filaments are called as the sporophores. Okay, and the project above the colony and give rise to spores, which are distinct from the endospores. Endospores are the spores which are found in the some specific kind of bacteria, but these streptomyces have some different spores. This is the size, this is the diagram of the streptomyces, and they are the tip at which the mycelium is generated in this manner. So this is the mycelium of the streptomyces, which can be found, and from the tip they grow in various places. So these are the various different types of species of Streptomyces. They are example of different types of species of the Streptomyces. So this is the life cycle of the Streptomyces. This is a spores. After germination, this is the germinating spores. And when the vegetative growth of spore is found, they grow into, they take into the vegetative mycelium. This is a vegetative mycelium of the Streptomyces. And after vegetative mycelium growth, they go to the aerial growth. So from this tip, they go to the aerial growth. So these are the aerial hyphae of Streptomyces. And again, they go to the sporulation phase. Okay. After the age increases of the Streptomyces, they again go to the sporulation phase. So these are the sporulated chains. And when the age is completed, they again converted into the single type of cells. And the cycle begins in this phase again. These germinating spores will take form into the vegetative spores, and this vegetative spores will get into the mycelium. Mycelium will take into the aerial hyphae. Aerial hyphae will take into the again spores chains, and from the single spores, they will again convert into the complete Streptomyces. So this is the diagram of which indicate the growth of Streptomyces in the culture media. These are the growth of Streptomyces in culture media. This is the diagram which indicate how the spores are formatted. This is the vegetative structure, and the hyphae is formed, and after formation of hyphae, spores are generated in the chain form. This is the morphology of spore bearing structure of the Streptomyces. They are the spore forming chain, and this is the tip. So from various strip size they can be identified. So these are the examples of different species of Streptomyces. They can be seed, they can be flexures, they can be spiral, they can be closed spiral. So they can be mono verticillate the spiral. So according to these characteristics of spores, chain of the spores, these Streptomyces can be identified. So the basic structure for identification of these Streptomyces is the identification by their chain of spores. Okay, using spores chains, then we can identify them. This is also a diagram. This is a chain of the conidiophores of Streptomyces. Ecology of Streptomyces. They are aquatic in nature. Primarily, they are also found in the soil. They produce some metabolite called geosmins, which are responsible for the earthy smell of the ploughed soil. They prefer alkaline to the neutral soil, and nutritional requirement include a versatile wide variety of carbon sources. They produce extracellular enzyme for utilizing starch, cellulose, hemicellulose, protein, fats, and lignin. 50 distinct carbon sources can be found. So these all about the Streptomyces. Next we will come to another video. Thank you very much.